I'm just admitting a couple of people that are coming in. Welcome, welcome, welcome. Olivia, where's your face? I know you. Hello, Avery. Hello, Sam. How's it going? And then there's somebody trying to connect to audio. Hey, good to see you. Thanks for joining us, Olivia. Olivia, you might have already had a little bit of this conversation, but I can give you some exercise if you would like. I'm just happy that you're hanging out, by the way. And perhaps we can talk about something interesting for you as well. Meanwhile, we're waiting for everybody else. Are you familiar with A Sprite, Olivia? No?
A Sprite.
Yeah. Are you familiar
with
that?
Yeah. I didn't buy it yet, but
there's a free version that the developers released, right?
I know there's a free version where you cannot save your files.
You can save.
Oh, okay. If there's one, I would like to download. Yeah, because I tried doing pixel art on Procreate.
Yeah, it's a little bit tougher.
It's a bit awkward on. Yeah, I would like to do it on Respray.
Well, meanwhile, we're waiting for everybody else. I'm just gonna give a couple more minutes. Let me send you the link. I got the link for that, and then we can get started right away. Where is the other student that sent me this? And I could talk about what I'm talking about in a bit to everybody else. All of you are probably like wondering, like, what the hell are we talking about? There we go. So Olivia, do you have 7-zip available with yourself? Do you know what 7-zip is, maybe? Sorry, I can't see you.
Yes,
you have? Okay, so I'll send you that. Basically, they made that version open and available for everybody. It's open source, but you have to be able to build it from source, which means it's just a fancy way of saying you have to compile the code yourself. So they expect you for you to be a little bit geekier, but some of our instructors that are geekier on the like Anita on the game design side, they have actually compiled it for us. So I'm just sending you the zip file that if you unzip it, make sure everything's on the same boat and it should work just fine. Okay. All right, let's get started, folks. Hey, Lenny, is that Lenny that I used to have in my class back in the day? Is that the Lenny that I know? Let me know if you can see my hand over here. I think that's the Lenny, but we'll figure it out. All right, let me pull out my presentation and we can start talking. So, welcome everybody. It's a pleasure to have you all join this little workshop. Let me get rid of the funky music. We can turn it on later if we want to chat more. But hopefully you can hear me a little bit better now. So, first of all, I just want to say nice to meet you, or nice to meet you all to this wonderful evening. I appreciate everybody. Welcome, welcome. I appreciate everybody to make some time in your day for us. And before we get started, I just want to get to know some of you in here. So I'm going to tell you a little bit about who I am. And then right after that, I'm going to start asking all of you, who are you? Okay. So can I get maybe in chat or maybe in camera, just like a yay or something to tell me if you can see my presentation, just to make sure, because I am notorious for sometimes forgetting to share it. You can see it?
Yes, we can.
Yes, awesome. Thank you so much. All right. So my name is Diego de la Rocha. I go by he, him, they, them. Feel free to use either of the pronouns. I'm an animation instructor at the 3D Animation and Foundation programs for KPU. I also teach at the visual effects and foundation programs, which is where my heart lives. And if you ever have any questions regarding anything about animation, please don't fret and send me an email. Let's geek out. I'm always happy to talk more. Something about myself, I would appreciate if you folks refer to me just by my name or any of these prefixes, if that's what you want. I just don't vibe with this kind of stuff, but it's just a request. It's not a big deal. But more importantly, a little bit about myself. I'm into super cute stuff. So if you ever want to talk to me about cute little animals, you have my heart, you have my interest. I myself have been in the indie developers in the industry for video games for most of my career. I've worked on animation, I've worked on advertisement, and a little bit of cinema here and there. And maybe most of my work, it's definitely on the underground side, but maybe you're familiar with some of these stuff. The last game I worked on was I was a teenage exocolonist. Maybe you might be familiar with that, maybe not. I think it released 1 year ago. Maybe I'm feeling a little bit old. But yeah, it was lots of fun to work on. But I find that most people get to know me or know me more from a little cameo that I have. I didn't work too much on this game, but I was very fortunate to do a little bit of voice acting or voiceover acting for a little game that happens to have a little goose on it. So that's basically me, but that's kind of the boring part. I want to get to know all of you. And if you don't mind, I know it might be a little bit, it might feel a little bit shy since we don't know each other yet, but I would really appreciate if you tell me something about yourself. So what we're going to do is I'm just going to call somebody randomly in here, and hopefully you can come in on mic. If not, chat is totally fine as well. And I'm just going to ask you, how would you like me to call you? Because sometimes what comes in here in Zoom is not what you actually want me to use. Feel free to disclose your pronouns, but you don't have to whatsoever. If you don't, not a problem at all. I'm just going to default to they, them, to make sure everything is as inclusive as possible. And more importantly, I want to know something about yourself. Just like I told you that I'm into cute things. Perhaps maybe you're into baking. Maybe you're into going for a walk. Maybe you're into animals. I just want to know a little bit more about yourself. So if it's okay, perhaps what I can do is I can start with Sam. Are you there? Hello, Sam. Nice to meet you. You're there. Nice to meet you. You want to type or do you want to come in on mic? Your mics are broken. Not a problem at all. It's a pleasure to meet you. Do you want to tell us anything about yourself? Does anybody want to help Sam? Meanwhile, Sam is figuring things out. Oh, you're super into SFX makeup art. Oh my gosh, that's so cool. Have you done it already? I have no knowledge whatsoever how it works, but I am a big fan of all those like prosthetics. You go by Shide. It's a pleasure to meet you. Thank you so much. I am a big fan of all those like old prosthetics characters like they use in the movies. So that's super cool. It's a pleasure to meet you, Sam. Sam, would you like picking the next person to talk to us? You took a full prosthetic course. That's so cool. I would love to know more about it if we have some time. Next person, Avery. Hello, Avery. I hope I'm not butchering your name. How's it going? Hello, you want to tell us something about yourself? And it could be as simple as maybe you like bananas, maybe you like strawberries or cherries, right? You know, it doesn't have to be anything too fancy. I just want to know. I find that I remember folks a little bit easier that way. You love video gaming. You're very surprised. Oh, when you figure out I worked on Untitled Goose. You know, it's really funny because it's probably the game that I've spent the least amount of effort and time in my life. And it's the one that I get recognized for the most. A couple of friends that were doing the sound design, which were actually doing the proper work in there, they just asked me if I could come in and help out with a little bit of voiceover acting. And they were like, oh yeah, you wanna help me on this random goose game? And of course, at that time, we had no idea it was gonna go that viral. I guess I feel pretty privileged to have been a little tiny bit, but if you play it, you might hear my annoying voice in there as well. It's a pleasure to meet you, Avery. Do you mind picking the next person, please? Oh, you go by Hihim. Thank you so much. How about Christina? Hey, Christina, how's it going? I guess they're calling.
Hi, I'll show you my day. And my shirt, it's a winning day for my shirt. Everyone loves my shirt. I'm Christina, pronouns she, her. I am really into very unrelated to what we talk about today here, but like bakeries, like going to different coffee shops and trying bakery items and making sure, you know, good coffee also has good pastries, that kind of stuff. Yeah, that's me. Who's Cam?
Cam, you've been picked, and also nice to meet you again, Christina. I love anything food, so I can appreciate the baking.
Yeah, and your voice is very lovely.
Thank you. Hello, Cam. How's it going? You want to tell us something about yourself? Are you the person on that thumbnail? Seems like you're riding perhaps a motorcycle, maybe a sports bike. I'm interested. I'm intrigued. Cam is my dad. Oh, hello, dad. Hello, offspring of dad. Oh, one second. I'm bringing in some of our students. Is that Harry Gomez? Some of our students from the school are coming in. Hello, welcome, Harry. Join in. Turn on your cameras. Nothing to see here. Move along. Cam is my
Lenny.
Lenny, yes. I think Lenny was my student. I might be wrong.
Hello.
Hey, Lenny. Hey. How's it going?
Diego, it's been so long.
Yes, I'm so happy to see you.
Yeah.
You're in term five
six.
Right now.
Term six. I'm doing final project.
How's that going? Are you specializing in modeling or are you specializing in animation?
I'm specializing in animation.
Yes.
Yeah, so I'm doing animation. So sometimes I even look back your previous classes. It's really helpful when I'm kind of stopped.
Awesome.
It's really helpful to review the traditional stuff, the traditional class, you know.
I could not be happier to hear that. Maybe you can share with us your reel in a second once we are done with the presentations. Would that be cool?
Yeah, I can show what I'm doing right now.
Awesome. Yeah. I can give you privileges to share screen. So everybody, this is Lenny, Olivia, and then Harry's hiding over there. These three folks are in our classes already. Hey, hello, Harry. How's it going? Welcome. Join us. The more the merrier. Are you sharing screen, by the way?
Just a moment. Okay.
And let us know if you can see. I think I have to stop sharing mine, perhaps. And we'll get back to Chang in there, or YJ Chang. I'm sure I'm butchering your name. I'm so sorry. Oh, there you go.
So
Nice to meet you, Wilmington.
In term three, we're having three projects.
Let me take a look. That's lovely.
So we have 3 months to work. So we have each project, three projects for each month. So I have body mechanics and some lip sync acting. Now I'm gonna play right now.
Oh, this is fantastic.
So thank you so much for sharing on this. I just missing of the lighting and rendering stuff and some polishing.
This is awesome, Lenny. Oh my gosh. Like, it's been a while since I see you. I feel so happy. We should talk. I want to discuss a little bit more in there, but so far it looks so cool. I love all your shots. I don't think you shared your audio, so I couldn't hear the lip sync, but it's a good thing. If I feel engaged, even without listening to the audio, that's already a good indication. So I think it's going to be good. How long do you have left to work on that?
So the first shot, I was working at last term even. Last term final project. So it took very long. So even more than a month, I believe.
Looks like a lot of work.
Yeah, but the other stuffs for each project for each month. So it left 2 weeks. I still have time to polish them.
Well, keep me updated. Lenny, so we're introducing ourselves just because there's a bunch of new people. Do you wanna, seen your reel, but do you wanna introduce yourself a little bit just to the rest of us?
So my name is Lenny. I'm in term 6. I don't know, what should I say?
Anything, remember, tell us, what are you into? Like Christina just told us, she's into baking, I'm into cute stuff.
Yeah,
for walks, maybe.
So this semester was very busy, but so I couldn't do my hobbies, but regularly, I need to computer games. So that's, and watch animations. That's why I'm trying. I decided my professionality to make animations. You know, it's very cool when I see the great cinematic set games and the animations, especially the Spider-Verse that recently I watched.
Oh yeah, that movie was great, eh?
Yeah.
And it's animated all traditionally, but I'll stop with that. Lenny, do you mind picking a next person so that they can introduce themselves?
Let's go with Olivia.
Sure. Olivia, you've been summoned.
Hi, my name is Olivia, and I'm in term 1 3D, and I just finished the Evos class this morning, and I look funny because I'm wearing a hair mask right now. I like playing games, and I recently made a couple games for game jams. They're called Stanley Problems.
You want to share your link of your game? Perhaps people in the audience can play it in their time. Yeah.
Please review and comments.
Send us that link in chat.
And then Yeah, I made one more game called Mad Mod Kumar, but it's unfinished right now and we're updating it. So yeah, it's been fun. As an animator, I can work with games, so it's amazing and I love it. Please play Standing Problems.
Send us the link and we'd love to check it out. It's a pleasure to see you again, okay. Olivia. Thank you for joining us. Do you mind picking somebody else? I think we're missing YJ Chang.
Yeah, sure. Go? YJ Chang.
And sorry if we're pronouncing your name wrong. I'm sorry.
Yeah, it's correct. I'm Yongjin, and you can call me Ren. And I'm from VFX Turn 3. So, yeah, I think in the future I'm more interested in lighting. So yeah, and a few years ago I was doing modeling and texturing. I graduated from VFX Vancouver Film School 3 years ago.
Oh, fun times! Yeah. I also went to VFS back in the day. Yeah. It's a pleasure to meet you.
Yeah,
nice. You said Ren, right?
Yeah.
Gotcha. Pleasure to meet you, Ren. I also love lighting, so if you ever want to talk, always happy to. Do you mind picking the next person? I think we're missing one or two. Cam, did you go? I think you said something about your dad helping you with the phone, but I think, oh, you don't know if your dad is listening. That's good. Maybe your dad can help us join. Oh, no, that's Sam. nothing to see here. Move along. That's okay. If you're feeling shy, that's all good. Diego, you want to come in and introduce yourself? I think you're the last one. Diego is also another student of us. Hey, Diego.
Hi.
We have students from all the program, but we also have potential students that are trying. They're trying to figure out if they want to stick around or not.
Oh, perfect. Well, I'm Diego.
Where's your face?
I'm sorry, because I just You're started eating. Setting everything. So
Oh, good.
I don't have my camera yet, but I'm Diego. I'm from Mexico. I'm studying term two for animation, 3D animation and modeling. And yeah, it's great. The class with Diego, it's one of the best ones. So let's hope you enjoy this kind of workshop, a little workshop here.
Oof. Too much, what's the work?
Too much pressure.
Too much pressure. I'm so sorry. I'm going to apologize already in advance for disappointing everybody. But thank you so much for the lovely words. Look at that. Olivia just posted a link in there. Everybody go and raid the super lovely video game that Olivia just worked on with a bunch of the game design students. Super cool. I wasn't able to finish it the other day, but I was taking a look. It looks lovely. So is this kind of like a take on the Stanley Parable game or something like that? Yeah, I'll stop it right now just because it's too loud. But all of you go take a look at it. Okay, so it is. I was wondering. That's awesome. You did a great job. By the way, for whoever hasn't figured out what these game jam things are, you take 2 or 3 days. How long did they give you to work on this?
Yeah, but I had assignments to work on, so I only worked on this for 2 days or three.
Fantastic. So all of these students joined together and did a game in 2 days, which is...
Yeah, they all had assignments, so maybe like 3 2 days average.
This is awesome. So I encourage everybody to go check it out. Sounds good. Thank you, everybody, again, for joining us. I'm just happy that you can be around with us. I know I've seen some of you on the Animation Club. I've had some of you as students. But maybe you've had a version of this class before with me. Maybe you haven't. But I think I'm always happy to have a recap, right? And hopefully by the end of today, we can do a little exercise to get your brains going. If you've taken class with me before, do not feel that you have to do just the basic exercise. I want to encourage you to go further, and I can actually even bring out some other presentations to give you more funsies. Let's ask the folks that haven't taken my classes yet, what do you think animation is? Sam, what do you think animation might be? And I'm sorry if I put you on the spot. Just let me know if you have the bandwidth to answer. Or if you don't, you can always pick somebody to help you out. Maybe Avery. Oh, like adding movement and life to something still. Okay, let's do some brainstorming together with everybody. Okay. So Sam says it's potentially, no worries, take your time typing, okay? Adding movement and life to something still, perhaps. Who else wants to add to this definition? Take away, agrees, disagrees. Who wants to give it a try? What else is animation? Exaggerating movement. Avery, you have, is Avery your first name or your last name? Whichever of those two it is, you actually have the name of one of the first name. Okay, so you have the name of that another animator, a really famous animator used to have, that is actually fantastic at exaggerating movement. So it actually gives me lots of good vibes. Are you familiar with Tex Avery? Maybe you are. I could imagine you've heard of the name perhaps. So exaggerating movement, what else do you think it could be? What was the name of our lighting friend, VFX student? What was your name again?
Me?
Yes.
Ren.
Oh, Ren. Ren, what do you think animation is?
Animation is art.
Animation is art. Done. Drop the mic. Now, it's fine if folks that have had class with me, let's see if you remember, what is animation? Do you want to add to this definition? Olivia, do you remember what we've been talking about in class? What is animation?
So like pictures moving frame by frame, so it looks like it's moving, gives us the illusion of movement, persistence of vision.
Okay, so both you and Sam are kind of close, right? Adding movement, perhaps, life, to something still, pictures moving frame by frame. Sam, how do you think that happens, right? Let me show you this picture. Has anybody seen, and maybe if you've been on a class, maybe you've seen these, I've added these lately. But has anybody seen these before? I feel like Olivia is the only one that has seen this iteration of the class, or maybe Diego, I don't remember which one. Avery, Sam, have you seen these paintings before? You haven't? So you're not even familiar with what they are? Let me give you some idea of what they are. These paintings are some of the earliest cave paintings that we've found from humanity. They're like thousands of years old. We barely know why they were painted. We barely know, like, we obviously don't have context because there was very little history recorded in at that time. But can you notice if there's a little bit of animation happening in these paintings? Can anybody see some sort of animation going on in here? The legs? Tell me more about the legs. What do you find on the legs? The legs are in two different spots to show movement. Maybe, right? And now we cannot talk to those humans back then. We can only assume, right? But I'm willing to bet that they're trying to explain through their painting or through their drawing that there's locomotion or movement happening in here, that these animals are alive somehow, right? And let me show you how before computers or anything, this can actually make sense. A bunch of researchers a bunch of paleontologists of these paintings. Sorry, I'm just reading the legs. The legs are in two different spots to show movement. A bunch of researchers and paleontologists got together and did a little example of what this could look like if you separated them together. Look at that. It's like this animal is kind of running. And this is one of the pictures. You can take a look at more of these pictures later. I can give you the link if you want. But there's so many cave paintings in that area. They're in what we now know as the area of France. And look at that. Lots of funny horses, right? You thought that TikTok was something new. Oh, somebody's just coming in. Welcome, welcome. Hello, Milan. Is that a Milan that I used to know from another term? Welcome, welcome. If not, tell me more. But check this out. All of these ones are outlines that have been photographed from the cave paintings from before. I find this super fascinating because it tells us that the history of animation is way older than the first computer, and it's way older, thousands of years older than the first camera. And if that's true, then we have lots of work to do to be able to understand animation, right? Welcome, Milan. Is that a Milan that I used to have in my class, perhaps? Or is this a new Milan? If you're new, nice to meet you. My pleasure. Hopefully you can cozy up and join us in the class. Who wants to tell me what is this? Lenny, have you seen this before? I don't think we've talked about this one before.
I don't think so.
What do you see in here?
I don't see the second one clearly, but seems like it's running.
Seems like it's running.
Or sitting. I barely see the legs.
And that's okay. It's some sort of animal. And remember, this is thousands of years old, right? So it's whoever took care of it kind of took care of it enough. And hello, Milan. Now I know who it is. Welcome back. Welcome back. What do you think this is made out of?
Stone?
Maybe. Close to stone, but it's really not stone. Anybody has a guess? Avery says clay. Maybe, but not really. What else do you think folks back then would be using to create materials? And it's lasted thousands of years. I'll give you a hint. It starts with B.
Bronzeware.
Wait, what?
Bronze.
Bronze? Oh, you're like going in the periodic table trying to figure out which one it might be. I'll give you a tip or a hint. It starts with B and ends with an E. What could it be? Something that you have access to. Made of calcium. Yes, Harry's got it. Come back to life, Harry. Tell us what you think it is.
Well, I know, Diego. I would be cheating if I say it right.
Well, tell us now. It's a good time.
It's a bone.
It's a bone. Thank you so much for the hint. But I appreciate the engagement. Yeah, so this is made out of bones. And it actually doesn't really matter what material it is about. I just find it really interesting. But check this out. Can you see what's happening in here? Can you have an idea of what these might be doing? Animating Avery, perhaps? Let me show you. Obviously, I don't have that tool myself in here. If not, I would be doing it in here. But if I use no video, obviously we're recording and you are seeing video through Zoom, but it would work the same even if you were looking at it just in person. If I just go between these three images and I do it fast, I'm just going up and down. Can you start feeling that this becomes alive? Have you ever seen an example like this? What do you think is happening in our brains for us to be able to get these phenomena? It has a name, and Olivia gave it away by mistake earlier. But there's a phenomena, and there's something happening in our brains that allows us to be able to see these. What do you think it might be? Does anybody know the name that hasn't taken this class? Sam, you want to give it a shot? How the hell are we able to see these before we have computers, before we have cameras, and still be able to see animation, right? Sam says stop motion. By the way, spoiler alert, we're going to be doing some stop motion in a bit. But for you to be able to do stop motion, you need a camera. But this is thousands of years where we don't even have cameras. We don't have electricity. We don't have film. How do you think we can do it just with our brain? What do you think is happening? It's a good guess, by the way. Ren, you want to give it a try since you haven't taken this class as well?
I don't know what is they called, but just a round stuff and you spin the equipment.
Oh, so the name of the equipment that the Europeans gave it thousands of years later is a thaumatrope, right? So that's what we're looking in here. But what I'm trying to figure out is if you know what is the name of the phenomena, something happens in your brain that allows you to see these. And it's the same phenomena that allows you to do visual effects, not just animation. Olivia, you want to help us out?
Something vision.
Persistence. Yes.
Persistence of vision.
Persistence of vision, right? So persistence of vision is the phenomenon that we understand right now, and we don't understand it 100%, but we understand enough that our brains go through a bunch of chemical reactions when light goes through our eyes, and it registers an image. And that image stays there for a little bit. And when there's movement, including my hand moving, the brain registers what happened before and what happens after, and it shows us something that feels magically moving, and it kind of comes to life. So basically, all these people were doing back in the day is, of course, they were doing animation, but they were understanding an optical illusion to be able to create persistence of vision. And therefore, that's the only tool that we need to be able to do animation. Of course, nowadays, we use all these fancy tools, computers, pencil, we use paper, all this stuff to do animation, right? And we can have lots of fun with that. But where I come from in terms of understanding animation is the traditional side. And I think it's super important for us to just have a base ground understanding of where and how can you do the most simple way of animation, because if you can understand this, then the knowledge scales and you can use it on whatever you want. Lenny was telling us that Lenny loves the movie for Spider-Verse. Has anybody seen the movie recently, the one that just came out, or the one before that? They're basically using the same thing. They're using persistence of vision, right? And all of you that have taken my class, you know that you're just doing comma and dots on Maya, right? And that's basically the same thing. You really liked it? Awesome. Yeah, I just went and saw it with a bunch of my friends that had the privilege of working on it, and they were like telling me all the little details. I can't speak of everything, but it was really fun to just hear them out. So we just figured out why do these drawings work. We figured out that it's persistence of vision. Now, have you ever done a flipbook in class before, perhaps? Maybe you were in math class or in science class, or we insert whatever class you didn't like and you were not paying attention and you're like, oh no, I must do a drawing. And somebody perhaps showed you that if you flip a bunch of paper together and you go, you get to see a little bit of animation. Has anybody done that? Let me show you a flipbook in here. You have? Awesome. Well, that's exactly what we're going to be doing today, because the stuff that I just showed you in terms of persistence of vision, it really just comes down to doing flipbooks. Now, you can do the flipbook with paper and pen and pencil. If you don't have any cameras, if you don't have anything else, that's all you really need. Find some pencil, find some pen, markers, whatever you want, and some paper. That's one option. However, we can also do some stop motion if you want. And that's what I'm going to be using as my desired medium for today. But let me show you how in here, when this flipbook was happening, if I was to flip through it myself, I know this is a video, but if we were in person, it would work the same way, right? If I flip through it very little by little, I'm just flipping, right? But if I go it really fast, even if I'm not pressing play, persistence of vision is happening. So that's all we really need to understand, right? And for 1 hour that we have, and I know I'm already kind of late, but I'm going to stick around until we finish. We can talk about how we can do this, right? So I want to encourage everybody to just join me. For all of you that have done this before in my class, that did the ball, maybe the bouncing ball and all of that, feel free to join me and I'll give you another exercise that actually is going to challenge you a lot. But I want you to, first of all, get some pen and paper or pencil and draw your favorite animal. See you tomorrow, Harry. Thank you so much. That's all good. Enjoy your classes. I want you to draw your favorite animal doing one action with a minimum of two drawings, right? Because for you to be able to flip it, you need at least two drawings. Do as many drawings as you want. Now, don't get too excited, right? Because if you do too many drawings, then you're not going to have the time to actually do it with any other material. If you have around you some soil, some sand, perhaps some clay, feel free to join me with that. You don't have to do that. But I want to show you an example of what I did in one of our classes in the foundation program. And I want to encourage all of you to join me in this. So if you give me one quick second, I'm just going to open the presentation from that because I just got that impromptu feeling that I want to challenge all of you to push for some funsies. So let's do this. Animation, presentations, and let me pull this out. So here's what I'm talking about. Check this out. I grabbed a piece of paper. I planned how a ball is going to become a little piggy. And of course, if we were taking classes, this is usually the final project because it actually is a lot of work. But I feel like it's also really fun to just get into it. Even if you don't understand anything, just give it a try, right? Doesn't matter. Whatever you get is going to be lots of fun. And I want to show you what I got, right? So I just planned out a bunch of key moments that are going to happen in the transformation of this ball becoming a little piggy, right? And I'm going to be using clay for my specific example. And here's what I ended up with, okay? So I just was taking a bunch of pictures. You gotta go, Milan. Thank you so much. All of you that have class at 7, thank you so much for joining us. See you around. But all of you that don't need to go, you're more than welcome to stay. So this is what I did for that presentation. I'm here to help you, of course. Like I know specifically for Avery and for Sam and for Ren, maybe perhaps you haven't done animation specifically. But I'm happy to help around, okay? So this is what we're going to be doing today. It doesn't have to be this piggy. It doesn't have to be this complicated. Let me...
Diego's computer died, but he's restarting his computer and he'll be back soon.
Hi. Just updating you that Diego, his computer died and he's just restarting. So hang in there.
So sorry about that, everybody. My computer decided to do a Windows update, as it always happens on the worst time possible. it does happen. Welcome back. Thank you for sticking out for whoever actually did. I appreciate it. Sorry for the technical issues, but we're back. Let me just bring out my presentation again because everything turned off. But I was almost done showing you what the little exercise that we're going to be doing today is, and then we can just get to it, okay? So let me just share my screen. Can you show me faces so that I can see if you can see my screen or not? If possible, if not, it's okay. Let me bring out the little presentation. So that I can give you the example. Okay, beautiful. Okay, so I have, you cannot see the screen? You can see it? Okay, good. Thank you, Christina. So I have the little example over here. Again, this took me a while. I've been doing this for a while, right? But I just want you to have fun. I want to show you what one of our students did. They sculpted a little ear, and then they destroyed it little by taking pictures one at a time. And then we reversed the animation. And then you can feel like it's kind of getting created out of nowhere. So that's another option that you can do. I don't think I have the file in here, but another option that we could do is we could try doing a little walk cycle, whichever you want. But let me know what materials you have. Avery and Sam, I'm not sure if you have some clay available around you, maybe some soil, maybe some sand. If you don't, let me know what you have available. And if you have nothing available next to you, even if it's just pencil or paper, it would be good. Or your fingers, if you have some fingers available, we could also use those, okay? Just let me know what you're gonna be using so that I can help you out. And let me just bring out my camera that I have over here so that I can show you kind of how you go about things. Dragon frame. And I'm going to bring out the presentation where I can explain you. Where's my presentation? Would you like to send the problem? I do not want to send the problem to Windows. It was just updating. And here's the presentation that I want to show you. And let me just turn on the camera over here. You will see that my camera in here freezes for a second. That's expected. Can you see my little hands? There we go. I'm back in business. So you have little camera. Let me make it a little bit lighter so you get to see my hands in here. We're going to get some focus. And I'm going to show you how you can do it right with your phone. Okay, so lots of options. If you don't have a phone, if you don't want to do any of pictures, you can do it just with a flipbook. That's easiest option, right? If you have a phone and you're not like me, where you have a super old flipbook, then what you can do is you can go to cateater.com right away and you can fetch this app. It works for Windows, I mean, for iOS and Android, doesn't matter which one you have. And you can download this app for free. There's a paid version. You don't need to pay for it. Everything that we're going to be doing is on the free version of this, okay? And I'm going to ask you to download it. I will be demoing on another software that we use in the industry because I actually work in stop motion professionally. But all the settings that I'm going to be using in that, just to be able to show you over here, is exactly the same that we have on the phone. And the way this app works is actually quite simple. You just find a place to put it on, find a light, and then we can start taking pictures. And one at a time, we do some stop motion. Do we have any questions so far on how to download this app? Lenny, Avery, Sam, anybody has any questions on this? Olivia? I know you have it. Are you there?
Yeah.
So I'm going to give you maybe a minute just so that you can find the app, take your time. And as you're finding the app, I'm just going to show you how you can think about doing this, right? So for this app to work, there's lots of things that you can potentially consider. You can consider the lighting. You can consider that the place that you're going to be doing in is a hard surface area. So floor is good. If it's carpet, it works, but it's going to be a little bit more challenging, right? So I would look whatever is hard surface area, if possible. Once you've got that, then I suggest you find maybe some books or something to place your little, how do you call it? Your little phone over there. And you're going to end up with a setup like this. Again, you're talking to an old school person that doesn't have a proper phone. I promise I'm getting one soon. But because of that, I don't have a phone and I did it with my fancy camera that I use at work. But it's exactly the same thing. You're going to have your phone looking at whatever you're going to be animating. It could be your favorite toy. It could be your hands and your fingers. It could be drawings. Doesn't really matter because all we need is persistence of vision. And for that, we just understand that we have different photos and then we put them together, right? And we're going to be using that app to put them together. So once you've got that, this is how you go about it on the app, right? Once you open the app, you want to make sure to create a new project, go inside new movie. Once you're inside that movie, then you're going to be presented with this little screen. On that screen, we're going to go into project settings right away. Make sure to set the movie speed to 12 frames per second or 24, whichever you want. Those two are industry standards. And then once you've got that, you can come back and then you can press over here where it says image captures. That's going to allow us to go into this little image, not image, but in this screen, where it basically works like any phone camera that you've ever used. And you just click and you take a picture, you move your character, take a picture, move your character, take a picture. I will do a little demo for all of you so that you could get to see. Obviously, I will not have time to do exactly what I did in this. This took me probably a full afternoon to be able to do it. And I was planning it out meticulously. And I ended up with all these pictures, right? because it's lots of fun. Again, this is usually a final project that I give students in our foundation classes, but I think you have the time that you have, right? So you can have lots of fun. And please don't let me stop you. If you want to keep going with this after this class ends, by all means, feel free to send me an email at diego.rocha@kpu.ca. And I'm super happy to take a look at your test later on. So once you have these, you can take pictures. But before that, I encourage you, this is optional, but I encourage you to go into the camera settings. And if you go on the camera settings, you can keep everything manual. Here's a little video that explains that.
Before you start animating, it is important to configure your camera settings. Not only to get a nice and balanced picture, but also to create exceptional techniques, such as light painting or certain filmmaking effects. Each phone, camera, or other device might show you different available parameters, but here are some general tips for your animation settings. If you leave everything in auto mode, unwanted effects such as light flicker may appear, so it's better to set as many features as you can manually. To do so, set the mode or M tab to manual. Now a bunch of new options will appear. The first one is the white balance, where you should set the light you are going to use. This will affect the color of the image. The next one is the focus. It is important to fix it on the right distance, otherwise it might change from one frame to the next one, creating kind of shaking effects. Parameters such as ISO and shutter speed depend on each other. You should set the ISO or sensibility as low as possible. Regarding the shutter speed, it is common to set it between 1/60th and 1/10th. Anyway, it is always better to adapt the settings to your needs.
Beautiful. So all of this is optional, but I just wanted to play the little video for all of you in case you wanted to get some ideas. Lots of things can happen, okay? Once you're good with all of that, to be able to export your movie, you can just click on that little button over here while holding your movie once you're done. And then you go export movie, and then you're going to have a little video of what you're doing. Does this make sense? Anybody? I know, Olivia, you've done this before. I don't know if we did this with you, Lenny. Did we do it? I don't remember. And you might be in class, so it's okay if you don't answer.
No, we might be.
You didn't do it?
Yeah, we did.
So please, well, I encourage you to do this. Avery, Sam, I know we haven't had class before. Do you have any questions? Let me know if I'm going too fast or too slow. I'm super happy to help however I can. Or if you just want me to go into the demo, I'm also super happy to just do that. Any questions so far? You think a demo would be nice? Let's do it, okay? Let me just do a little quick demo by going in here in my camera. Again, I'm using fancy software that is industry standard, but it doesn't change any difference whatsoever how you do it with your phone. So of course I can't show you the camera, but I'm already showing you the what the camera sees, right? So you're gonna have to place your phone or your camera wherever you want and just get it in there so that it doesn't move as much as possible. If it moves a little bit, it's fine, right? But it's part of it. And I have a little bit of clay over here, and I'm just going to get literally my hands dirty. and I'm going to start just kind of playing with it a little bit just so that it gets, it's been laying in there for a while. So it's not too warm yet. So I'm just warming it up so that I can mold it. Right. And it doesn't have to be a perfect shape. We can start with something like this. And let's perhaps just do something super simple where we have, let's do a character. And again, this could be whatever you would want. It's mostly for the sake of the demo. You can spend as much time as you want with this, and you can make your characters that are going to come alive much cooler than mine. I'm just giving you just a basic idea of how you can think about it. Okay. So I'm going to just put two eyes on this little character, then maybe a little face, and I'm taking the face out of the same place. Just give me a quick second so that we can have this friend or this new friend come alive. Okay. So there we go. Character has a little face, right? It's probably the most impromptu character I've ever designed, but it's going to do for us. Okay. So I'm going to make this character kind of come to life by destroying the character first. Okay. So what we're going to do is I'm just going to make sure I get enough light in here. I think I have a little bit too much. That's a little bit better. Once I'm ready, I'm just going to start taking pictures. So in your phone, remember, this is like it would look like in here, right? You would just press over here and you would take the picture. Of course, if we were in person, which usually this class I give in person because it just makes more sense for it to be in person. We usually do hybrids, depending on the type of class that we need. We either do it in person or online. And I'm going to take a picture. So I'm going to press enter in my keyboard. You probably can hear like a choo-choo, and my camera just took a picture. And check this out. Right now, I can toggle back and forward. And in your iPhone and your phone, you will be able to do this, where this is the picture that I took, and this is what's happening right now. All I'm going to do is little by little, I'm going to start taking pictures as I'm destroying my little character over here. Remember, this can be anything. And let me show you this. Just by three pictures, look at this. The character is already kind of becoming a little ball, right? So let's keep going over here. I'm gonna keep pressing on this character, take another picture, keep pressing on this character, take another picture. I'm gonna start thinking about how this is gonna do some squash as I'm pressing all of these, some of the principles of animation that we can talk about more while we're in class. Then little by little, see how our little face is stopping to be a little face. And using persistence of vision, I'm not using the play button. I'm just seeing how this is gonna come alive backwards, right? So I'm gonna go all the other way around. And I just wanna end up with a really smooth ball, little by little. Take another picture. And then just to add a little bit of flex over here, we can do a little bit of, let's see if that's going to work. That's going to be too much. Something like that. Yeah, let's do that. I'm going to make it settle a little bit at the very end, just by rolling as it's kind of becoming its thing. And I'm only using the theory of persistence of vision. Let's keep rolling this little friend. And as we're rolling it, we're also smoothing it out a little bit more. And again, this is sky's the limit, right? You can do whatever you want. I'm just having fun right now, which I think it's very important. Like, animation is very complicated and a very hard subject. But before you start like getting with all the complexities and all the principles and all of that, I think it's very important to just start having fun. Because if you can find the fun in it first, then later it becomes more fun to actually do the hard stuff, right? Like the stuff that Kenny was showing us, which is, I'm so excited to see, not Kenny, Lenny. I'm so excited to see the progress. That moved a little bit too much, but because I haven't taken the picture, life is good. Let's do that. A little bit of less acceleration, which is another one of the principles of animation. Using persistence of vision, I get to figure out if I want the picture or not. And then let's start settling. Little movements, just like, see, I just touched it a little bit compared to the other one. So let's do that. Doot, 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 doot. And now I'm gonna do more minute movements where you just kind of like, you touch it and you let it in the same place, see it? But see, from the other one, it just like, it just gives you a little bit of pizzazz somewhere in there, but I'm gonna push it a little bit to the other side because I want an arc to happen. Oh yeah, that's gonna feel lovely. Maybe a couple more pictures where I just like, I'm literally just saying hello to it. Look, very little. and then maybe another one towards there where I don't do much. You barely feel it. Maybe I want to feel it just a little bit more. This is like, there we go. That's all I want. So that it decelerates a little bit more. And then I'm going to come back just a bit to the other side so that it settles. So we go and it comes back to that. Maybe that was a little bit too fast. And now we're going to settle maybe a couple more pictures towards the other side. I'm just massaging it by now. Again, you don't have to be using clay. You can be using soil, grass, whatever you have available next to you. Doesn't really matter, your favorite toy, because that's the power of resistance of vision. You don't really need more. I'm going to take one or two more pictures and we're going to call it the day for this little demo. Let me just flip really quickly. Life is good. Now, if I just play it like this, it's going to feel kind of weird. Let me just play it for you. Where is the play button? Ah, here. Look at that. First of all, two problems. It's backwards. And the other problem is it's going maybe too fast, right? And the reason why it's going too fast is because we haven't really done anything with timing. The first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to play it backwards. On your software, on my software, I have a way to just say, play it on the other way. And I'm going to be able to just do that really easy. But on your software, even if you don't have that, that's not a problem. What you want to do is you're just going to grab the first one and place it at the beginning. I have a little presentation in here that shows you how you can do that. Let me just get back to the presentation to show you that. Here. Once you're done, you're going to be able to go into the software and you can actually drag and drop and play it backwards. Okay. So you grab the last one and you put it at the very end and so on. Just for the sake of time, in mine, I'm not going to drag and drop all of them because you get it. Like, I'm just going to grab this one. I'm going to put it over here. Then the next one, I'm going to put it over here and so on. I'm just going to press this button so that I can play it backwards. And at least it's playing, right? But everything is going too fast. So now in your software, what you can do is, let me just go to the software presentation. You can tell the software that you can hold it for longer time, each one of the pictures. So if you tap and hold the picture, once you've taken all the pictures, it's going to give you this example where you have a bunch of options. Look for the option that says pause. And once you click for pause, then you can change the numbers over here for how long you want to pause each one of these pictures, how many frames you want to hold it for. And once you do that, then a little number is going to appear over here. That's exactly the same as what I'm going to do in my software over here, which is different software, but it's the same idea. So I'm going to click in here and see this little number. That means the same picture is going to be displayed for two frames at 24 frames per second. And you can make it 15, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Here's an example. I can hold it for 4. I can hold this one maybe for another 3. And these, I just want you to play with it, right? Just enjoy. We haven't had any classes on all the specifics on the principles of animation, and you don't have to. I just want you to play. For how long do you want things to hold? How long do you not want things to hold? All of these ones I'm making pretty slow because I think there's not going to be too much. And when I say slow, I'm thinking three frames for a hold, maybe even 4 frames for a hold. And as it's starting to wake up, maybe we go from 3 to maybe 2. And maybe as it's starting to go a little bit faster, we keep going on 2. And then maybe these will start going maybe around here on 1s. And maybe we keep that on 1s. And maybe these we hold again on 3s because we want to be a little bit slower. Maybe I want this to be a little bit slower. And you just play with it, depending on how much time you want it to take. If you want it to be slower, you hold it for longer. If you want it to be faster, you hold it for less amount of frames. And once I go through all of these ones, which you can do on your phone as well, right? You're just going to repeat and rinse, right? You're going to hold, tab, press pause, then you're going to change the numbers over here, and you're going to be able to change each one of these ones in here. Once you go through all of them, you're going to have some sort of example, like in here where everything has numbers. Mine looks more complicated, to be honest, than what it should. Yours is just going to be a bunch of the same pictures, but with a bunch of numbers. And now I'm just going to press play. I'm going to go all the way to the end, and I'm going to press play. Look at that. It becomes alive. And again, this is a little demo. Of course, if you have more time and more energy, you can push yourself as much as you want to perhaps do something similar to what I was showing on the example over here. Does that help a little bit, Avery and Sam? I hope it's not too much. I know it, sometimes I'm notorious in my classes for giving maybe a little bit too much information. Do you have any questions? Lenny, I know you're probably doing it for the first time. I'm not sure if you're able to join us because you're also working on your final project. But does anybody have questions on this? Dun, 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 dun. And if there's no questions, that's also okay. Not a problem. What we can do is I can hang out for a bit. I can let you just do, and feel free to just ask me some questions. I can hang out for maybe another 15 minutes if that's okay with all of you. Try to do it. If you get stuck anywhere, I'm here to help you out. And otherwise, if you still want to keep trying it on your own time and you want to go forever and ever, don't let me stop you. Send me a message. I'm going to type my email over here, diego.rocha@kpu.ca. You can just reach out to me in there. And I'm super happy to talk specifics of animation. Send me your test. I want to see what you end up doing. Okay? Does that sound like a relatively decent plan, everybody? Sounds good. Thanks, Olivia. Awesome. So I'll play some music. Let me know what you got. I might do some animation as we're playing the music. I'll do some fun stuff perhaps. And then once we're done, then we can call the meeting adjourned. And please let me know if you have any interest in any of the programs from the animation department. Sweet beans, I'll play some music. Thank you so much, everybody, for joining us. Pleasure.
Thank you.
Thank you, Lenny. Olivia, Lenny, are you going to try doing a little character? I want to challenge you, Olivia. Why don't you do your next game with a stop motion character?
I'm not working on any game at the moment. I think, I don't know if I have clay either, so maybe I'll use like a digital drawing.
Yeah, that's okay. I mean, you can use whatever you want. No problem, right? As long as it's persistence of vision.
Yeah. Should I do a character or should I do like an object? Because I
up to you. I mean, I'm just trying to come up with ideas. I'm thinking perhaps maybe I should do a little snow person because it's so cold right now.
Are you sure it's cold? Well, I'm wearing layers.
I'm very sweaty right now. I'm just kidding. But
yeah, me too.
That's why I want to do a snow person, because maybe that's a way we can come back to life.
Oh, Avery just typed in the chat.
Oh, thanks, Diego. I think I'm going for now. Thanks a ton for all the information and animation. I think I'll check out the programs and hopefully join in sometime. Yes, please do. Oh, you're in high school. Oh my gosh, what a privilege. I wish. So it'll probably be in 2 years. What? Come by to the university anytime. You don't have to wait for high school to finish. Send me an email. And if you want to come by to the university and take one of our classes, I don't know how proper this is to be or not, but just send me an email and we can arrange. Perhaps maybe you can sit in on one of the classes and give you a better idea of how it would be. Always happy to talk. Okay. And I'm excited that you're excited about it in early times in high school. I hope your teachers don't hate me too much, because now you're going to be doing so many flip books. Just make sure you pass enough grades so that you can actually join us, okay? I don't want you to flub your high school because you're doing flip books all the time. But if looking back, if I was doing high school again, I think I should have done more flip books, because it would have helped me more in the job that now I have, right? So you never know what you end up doing. But it's a pleasure to meet you, Avery. I hope I see you sometime. Yeah, just send me an email. I can't promise everything, because, you know, sometimes institutions are institutions, but send me an email, and if we can figure it out, maybe we can we can get the folks from recruiting to make us join, and maybe we can do basically the same class, but we can do it in person, or maybe you could drop in one of the classes if you have questions, for sure. It's a pleasure to meet you, Avery. I hope you have a lovely evening, okay? Sam, do you have any questions? I know you were telling us that you have prosthetics. Do you want to share some of the prosthetics that you've done before? You said that you took a course of special effects. I'm very interested in all of that. It's so cool. It's like, if I had another time to study, that's probably something I would study. Oh, you know what? I'm going to make a little duckling. I think that's what I want to do. Do you have any links to your prosthetics? I don't know how much you have or haven't done. Yeah, you have stuff on your Instagram. Can you like send us a screenshot? I am as old as you can get and I don't have Instagram. I mean, I have one, but I don't have access to it right now. I forgot my password. You'd share screen but slow Wi-Fi. Can you take a screenshot and send us the screenshot, maybe? Would that be okay? Awesome. Let's do it. Show us your stuff. I wanna take a look. Cause the stuff that you probably do on those type of courses, it's likely super, super relatable. Especially if you're doing special effects in terms of like prosthetics and all of that. Have you ever heard about texturing in computer graphics? And I know you're taking a screenshot, so if you don't answer right away, don't worry. But there's like a whole realm in computer graphics where you actually get to paint. You're basically putting makeup on your characters. You have Okay, so if you give me a second, I can actually give you a quick demo. Let me just go wash my hands because I have clay all over myself. But give me a quick second. I'll be right back so I can wash my hands. Where is my thing to... There we go. I'll be right back, okay? I'm washing my hands. I am back. Let me log in into the computers that we have at school because we have access to the computers from home. So let me just log into it and load one of the files that we have so that I can show you some of that. Have you ever tried texture painting yourself in computer graphics? It seems like you understand what I'm talking about. But I'm not sure to what extent. So maybe what I'm about to show you, you already done. So struggling with tech stuff, I don't know how to, that's okay. Don't worry about it. You can send me an email and I'm happy to see what you're doing. Let me minimize all of that. And I'm just gonna bring in the computer from school and I'm gonna do some inception. And let's take a look over here. Okay, now I'm logged into the computer at school and I want to share with you, this is from one of our classes. You haven't done it personally? That's fair. And you know what? Unless you're doing this kind of stuff, most people don't do this. It's pretty niche, but that's what we're here for. So if I go into my, where did I save it? I saved it in here. I'm just finding the file so that I can show you. I went too far. Sorry, one second. Here, it's under Sophie, Blender. There you go. Okay, so you're actually getting one of the classes that I haven't even taught yet to any of the students. So you're getting a preview of what my university students are gonna be getting maybe in 2 weeks, because this is a new class that I just ended up planning. But don't tell them. So don't worry about all of this complexity. I'm just gonna go back into 3D land over here. And this is a super cool character that a bunch of people worked on, not myself. This is made by, so the concept art is made by Hong Sun Sang, and I'm probably pronouncing the name super wrong. And then somebody else did the 3D character base model. And again, I can't pronounce his name, Jae Young Nam or something like that. But these two people made this beautiful character. And then later on, they made this available for free to use for tests. And then I came in and I changed all the colors so that I can preview for our classes in school. And basically, I'm gonna give a class where we're doing some compositing and a little bit of visual effects for that, but I think we can use this character just to give you just a basic idea of how, like, the stuff that you know in terms of prosthetics and makeup 100% applies. And I will show you if I can get a hold of the texture. Again, I didn't paint this texture, I just repainted it basically. But basically, whoever did this character actually made a different, like, the colors are completely different. Let me just find the asset over here so you can see the original character that I downloaded from that super cool artist. So this is from the Autodesk Arnold series that you can download for free over at your place. You can start playing with this if you wanted to. But you can see this is the original character, Sophie, and we can actually go to the link of the person that created this, which is Jaeyoung Nam. And if I go over here to their link on their art station, this is their character that they created, right? It's super cool. I love the colors and everything. The only reason why I changed the colors is because I want to give a class where I show the students how to do that. But obviously you can see that the character that I was working with was a completely different color on their skin and everything. And I actually went through, again, I won't have time to explain the whole thing, but I just want to like bring you back into how I thought about doing all of that. So you basically use a bunch of math. You don't have to, you should pay attention to your math classes, but it's not, it doesn't have to be perfect, basically. So I used a bunch of math, and there's a bunch of ways to display the geometry. All of these colors that you see in here that looks like super funky colors, that's just coming out of mathematics. And out of those mathematics, I plugged it into this thing that basically allows me to change where in space those colors are going to be. And as I change it, it looks like it changes color, but all I'm doing is I'm just changing where in space those mathematics are, and it basically goes through the whole spectrum of colors. Again, it might be a little bit too much. Don't worry too much. This is like on more advanced classes. I'm just excited to show you. And this is what I wanted to show you. This little box that we see over here, which is called a node, and we use this on texturing. If I just go and find that in my assets folder in my computer, I'm just copy pasting the path. I'm going to open this over here. And if I find it in there, it's going to be Sophie Diffuse. Let me just find that over here. I'm going to double click that. And I'm going to get really close. And you will see that it's kind of like a picture. And there's a bunch of these pictures. I don't remember which one. Oh, there we go. This is the one that I wanted to show you. Can you see what's happening over here? Somebody, which is that person that created this character initially, actually went in and created an image, and we call these texture maps. I'm not sure if you've ever played video games in the past. I think, was it you or Avery that mentioned video games? But if you've ever been familiar with things like skins, perhaps in, I know Minecraft has skins at least. I know, like I'm so bad with like the new fancy games. I used to work mostly on the indie game industry. But basically you make a bunch of these maps, and those maps, you map them, excuse the pun, right? You map the maps towards, let me just find the UV editor in here so I can show you general UV editor here. So that's just another way of previewing the character. But if I get the map of this character, check this out. This is how we're mapping the information of the makeup to this 3D character over here. So it's not one-to-one, and let me, give me 1 second, my music went away. So it's not one-to-one, right? Like you're not painting directly, at least in this case, but I can actually maybe edit this and show you in a bit how we can do it. But I just wanna show you how, where it comes from, right? So this character, oops, where did it go? Sorry, I went too close. So this character is made out of this geometry, but this geometry is connected through those boxes that we call nodes, and it's mapping all the textures into this face. And somebody in Photoshop or in Blender or in Krita or in Procreate, whatever you wanna think about, it could even just be in drawing, and you can take a picture and put it back in there. As long as you consider this layout, you can actually start doing the makeup over here. Then after that person did it, right? Of course, they painted a different type of skin. Let's go back over here. Then I started playing with a bunch of mathematics, and I started changing the color. So in here, basically I went and I just told it to change the color over here. But the cool thing is I'm getting to keep all that extra blush and makeup that that other artist did, right? So I get to reuse it while changing the color. Then I change a little bit the brightness and the contrast. And last but not least, this looks all flat, but we want this material to react to all the lighting that we have in the rest of our scene, which this lighting can be manipulated. If I grab one of these lights, we can start manipulating all of these however you please. Look at that light, maybe too much, right? But I just want to show you that you can manipulate all of that. And that's how I ended up over there. And what I want to show you is I can actually open that same map. I can't promise that I'm going to be able to do it because sometimes this is a little bit buggy. And there's more specialized instructors on the 3D program and on the visual effects side. And I would say on the game design side as well, that do these for a day, leaving every single time. But they basically just paint over these. So let me see. I can't promise again if this is going to work, but I think it should work. Let's just grab a random color, like some green, and let's see if it lets me paint. Look at that. See how, as I put over there the texture, I'm able to start painting on that map. Obviously, we don't see green because over here in our map that we did over here, I'm just going to mute the extra things so that you get to see, hopefully, the little green that we've been painting. And perhaps we just want to see it over here. Let's see if we can paint in here. Nope, it's a little bit too buggy and it's not going to let us, but technically, if we kept painting over there with that green over here and I saved it on top of it, then I could just literally start doing some texture painting. And technically it's just, how do you call it? Makeup in computer graphics. I've seen those masks in some games by accident via glitches. Oh, yeah, it happens all the time. So this is a very top level explanation of how it works. Obviously, there's so much nuance to all of these. I'm just like trying to give you a very quick explanation. Let me just try and see if I can save this out, save as a copy. And I'm just going to call it Sam example. And I want to see if I can remap it. I don't know if it's going to work because this scene, I might break it a little bit, but if I just remap instead of using that texture and I now call your texture that we just created, let's find it. Some example over here. Cross your fingers and let's see if it reloads. No, I totally broke it. Never mind. It's okay. But if you talk to the proper texture instructors, they would be able to help us over here. I'm specialized in animation. I'm just a geek that I like to think about all the other sides. But yeah, I just wanted to show you that. I hope it was interesting. Also, I just sent you an email with your screen. Oh, let me take a look. Let me see. KPU. Sam, are you also in high school or what's your status in life? You found that super interesting. It's super cool to see all this. Yeah, it honestly, you can geek out on these forever and ever. There's so much that goes in there. And this is just the material. So if I can expand these, this is just the material for the skin, right? And this is a very simple material. You can get so complex to the point. So this class that I'm doing is actually for visual effects and compositing. Let's see if it loads because it's a little bit slow. Come on, don't die. I hope I didn't destroy it. There you go. So these, you can get as complex as you need to get as nuanced. So I'm showing the class moving forward how they can. So once you have already the image, we can actually come in and start changing the colors of each one of these characters, little areas, right? And you can start tweaking and fine-tuning everything that you need for whatever your needs might be. So it gets really dense, right? Obviously, lots of things to explain for this to make more sense, but I hope at least it gives you a little bit of interest in how it could look like. You're 23, you're looking for a career swap. Fair enough, I feel you. It's always, I think we're always trying to figure out that, right? I don't think I have figured out 100% what I want to do in life, but I think that's the fun part. Samia, I just got your email. Feel free to keep talking to me. Let me know if you have any questions further. We're gonna end up the meeting already because I'm 2 hours late. But please, we're an open book. However we can help, let me know, and super happy to talk more. Okay, and especially if you're looking for a career swap, feel free to ask me questions on what does the actual industry looks like and so on. I'm happy to connect you with some of the other instructors. If you like, as an instance, I just showed you very basics of texturing, but I am not a texture artist by whatsoever myself. I'm just a hack in that, but I can actually connect you with whoever is our texture artist instructor, Erica, and you could talk to her, and I'm sure you're gonna get so much more information from her than I can ever give you. But it's been a pleasure to talk to you. I got your email. It is KSK, right? Is that your? No, okay, that's another person. Sam. Okay, I got it. Oh, there we go. Let's take a look. Is it okay if I share these with folks? Look at that. So cool. That's nuts. That is really cool. Oh my gosh. Yeah, so this to me is magic, right? The same way I was explaining you kind of how it works, I want to know how this works. Sam, if you understand how you do this in reality, you're going to have so much fun in computers, I would say. Especially if you're into a little bit of techie stuff, right? It does get a little bit techie, but having the understanding of these, everything transfers, right? Like all the color theory that you understand to be able to do these, it just transfers. Latex and stretching the face, to be honest, like I love computer graphics and all the world of that we work in, but I wish we still lived back in the day where we didn't have all these computers doing all of these effects. Like I'm a big fan whenever productions actually bring out the actual prosthetics department. It's a little bit sad that it doesn't get used as much, but I'm hoping that filmmakers kind of do a comeback. And I think I've seen it a little bit more where it's a little bit more of a mix, because I'm a big fan of the traditional aspect. And that's why I teach on the foundation program, because I think it's very important to connect the dots of, yes, you're using the computer to do all this fancy, cool stuff, but it all comes back to reality and to the same principles that we were doing before, right? So for the foundation program specifically, we really like to focus and nail down on how you do the basics first and how does that connect the dots into the computer. And I think having a formation on those two things together usually makes a more well-rounded artist. But anyways, I'm just blabbering now. I don't want to hold you for more time. It's been a pleasure to meet you. Keep in touch. Do you all know, I guess Sam, you're the only person left that is a potential new student. Do you know have you been in touch with the folks from recruiting? If you have any other questions, do you have their contact? If not, I can give you really quickly their contact. Let me know. Just let me know that, and contact info would be great. Okay, let me find that. Where did I have it? I have it in my presentation, I think. I think I have it in here. Yeah, nope, I don't have it in there. Let me just fetch it for you really quickly and give me 1 second. So you want to contact very likely somebody called Liam. which is on the recruitment side for this kind of stuff. Give me one quick second. Oh, here it is. I have the contact. So it's Liam Bashaw. That is the person that you probably want to talk to. If it's not Liam, it's probably somebody called Nicole as well. But I feel if you just email Liam, you can probably go from there. Yeah, send us a message if you have more questions. And it's a pleasure. Thank you for joining us for 2 or potentially 3 hours, I think it was. And sorry for my computer doing a Windows update. You know, things happen. Thanks, everybody. I hope you all have a lovely evening. Have a lovely day.
Would you see my video before ending?
Yes, I would be super happy. Lenny, show me. You want to share your screen?
Did I just send you in the by the team?
Okay. Yeah, that's all good. Let me take a look. Oh, you animated. Okay, let's see. Let's take a look. I'm so excited. Yes, yes, somebody actually did the exercise. Let's take a look over here. And let's press play. Can I make it big? 1 second. I want to make it big. Here. Let's make it big, big, big. All right. I'm ready. What?
Well,
that's amazing.
At the end. Wow. So talented in origami.
Oh my gosh. You just did double flex. You're like, I'm doing stop motion with origami. Let me drop the mic. That's so cool. Thank you so much for this, Lenny. You just made my day. Lenny, one note, since you've been taking classes with us, have you played with the holds and with the timing on these?
No, I did. I couldn't do that. I don't, you know, I still kind of don't get the
okay, let me show you. Because I think if you play with your timing, this already looks really cool, but if you play with the timing, OMG, it's gonna look super cool. So on the app, you're gonna be able to see all the frames like these, right? These. Have you been able to do that?
Yeah.
Just tap. I don't know if it's tap and hold. It depends on the phone that you're
tapping.
Using. Yeah, so
it's tapping. I see a lot of menus.
Okay, click on the one that says pause.
Pause.
Okay, and then you're gonna get another menu, and it's gonna let you kind of like swipe around. And just use, so that, are you familiar with 2s, 4s, 3s? Remember we were talking about that?
Yeah.
That's basically how you can put these on 2s, on 1s, on 3s, on 4s.
So numbers means kind of how many.
How many frames you hold it for.
Yeah.
So I would go through these and really think about how long you want to hold each one of those for. It takes a little bit of time. But spend that time and then re-export it and send it my way, okay?
I see.
That makes sense?
Yeah.
Awesome. Sweet. Thank you so much. This is so cool. Oh my gosh. I'm freaking out. I love this stuff. Let me see. Yes. Cute flower. What a way to end it. All right, everybody. Let's enjoy our evenings. I love that it's still sunny outside. So thank you so much for joining me. I can't be more happy with this workshop. Let's try to see if we can do more at some point. Okay. See you soon. Bye-bye, everybody.
Thank you.
Thank you. Bye.